Nine!
This might not be good because Jiraiya said he was stowed somewhere and he is literally up next.
Well,
uh-oh.
Also, what's up, bitches?
What's up, motherfuckers?
What's up?
Well, does someone care to recap what happened last time?
We came into this giant city after suggesting that a group of people with a dragon don't attack us. And then we delivered some bad news about somebody who had died to some random-ass sheriff guy. And then we bought some shit, we traded some shit, and now we're fighting giants.
Yep. And just so you know, these giants that you're currently, like, the only one you... The rest of the city is able to, is taking care of the rest of the giants, so you only have to... So you guys will only have to deal with the ones you're currently... Pretty much the ones you're adjacent to. The ones you can see. Oh, I went and hid the rest of them. Because this is a major settlement. It makes sense that they'd be able to fucking defend themselves.
That's good, because I have a plan for this giant that I have done a lot of the damage to.
The NPC that I'm controlling reminds me of Donald Trump. Just look at him.
The NPC that I'm controlling reminds me of a glass figurine. Not even a cannon.
He looks about as sad as Donald Trump, but that's it.
It's just like, from the distance that he is from my TV to me, just like, every time I glance at him, it's like, why is Donald Trump on my screen? Anyway. Let's get this show on the road.
I still think it's funny.
Alrighty.
Duvessa is supposed to be the...
So when we left off, it was just coming to the turn of the ones that the characters that you guys are not controlling, you know, the giants, their wolves, and Mr. Southwell here. Of course, my dumbass forgot to open their sheets.
In the meantime, I'm going to have an ice cream ball.
Oh, that's wicked.
I am going to roast Duvessa as Maxwell. Here we go. You're such a useless bimbo. Thank you.
Okay. So the giant that's been throwing rocks throws another rock. Just chucks it over the... Chucks it, but this time he throws it through the gate. He just fucking throws it more into town than at somebody. See, the giant that's dead, still dead. The giant that is in melee range of everybody does the melee thing.
Uh-oh.
Do best to respond with, I can talk good. Shut up. I can talk better than you.
All right. He swings twice. What the fuck are these rolls?
Hello, I am Internet Dice. I am here.
Sirak takes 20 damage.
Ow. Out of curiosity, what was the attack roll for that?
21.
Yeah, no, his parry wouldn't have solved shit for that. Okay.
No, it wouldn't have.
And then... Vegeta, wait, is he here? I don't want to damage him if he's not here. Hey, Jid, you take 25 slashing damage.
Did you know that was all part of
that
was all part of Vegeta's plan to act like he wasn't here? Duvessa Shane.
Still logging in.
Please tell me how I can be just as useless as you in battle.
You really don't like this NPC you were given.
Each of the Winter Wolves pull up to one side of this Frost Giant. Ready to chomp, chomp, chomp. One of them, the one here,
rude.
Chomp, chomp, chomps on
I am up Sirak, power.
Knocking him unconscious.
Oh boy.
As it should. Aoife, you're going to use a lot of your healing spells on them rather than us, actually.
Same with Jed.
See, and the other one. Sorry, I gotta make a save.
Hey, but you finally got it.
Bites Mr. Southwell.
Just in time, too. Would you look at that?
And knocks him flat on his ass. In other words, prone.
That was rude. You don't have to say that I'm useless. Oh, shut it, you donut.
And then for his turn, he stands the fuck up and starts swinging at the wolf that just tried to fuck him.
The wolf tried to fuck him?
Not literally, but more metaphorically.
That sounds unhygienic. And how
it is
a different, that's and how we get a different STD.
Yes.
That sounds like something we don't need to talk about.
Yep, we're going to move on. It is Vegeta's turn.
Let's talk about that. Still loading.
Okay. Take your time.
Anyway, welcome back to Duvessa getting absolutely demolished by Maxwell. Okay. Honestly, where did you learn to use that knife? My mother, shut it. She didn't know how to use it except for cooking. And that's not a sexist joke. That is actually true because you can't do shite with it. Why are you so angry? Hun, you are on the front line in a fight that you have no place in being in. It's my city. It was your city. It is now our city, as we are doing most of the damage. See how that works? Now,
well, there are
and be quiet.
There is a significant number of giants more that the city guard is taking care of.
This is our part of the city. Therefore, we own this part of the city, as we are the ones protecting it mainly. The entrance.
So, my map's not loading. I see myself and the NPC that I control. So I don't know
try,
where I'm moving.
Try moving one of them. Just move one of them slightly.
You're so rude. Why are you so rude? You should not be in the front line, Duvessa. Ever in your life. Me one more chance. If it doesn't work, I'll call to the back. One more.
What are you giving her one more chance to do? Die?
No. Giving her one more chance to talk.
I think these giants made it obvious last time that they are not wanting to talk.
Well, we did just kill their leader, so I could possibly, maybe,
get the intimidation factor
on that fact. Off of that fact. But it's not likely.
All right. I'm all loaded in. Let's see what we got. All
right.
Ah, this giant needs to die.
Indeed.
Off the ball.
And
Goku, I'm real Super Saiyan.
Do believe Vegeta is still raging, right?
Yep. Should be.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And we're gonna hit him with some strength.
It's a 10.
And then I'm assuming he's still alive. So we're gonna spend a key point for flurry of blows. It's two more, right?
Indeed.
You should have multi attack by this point.
Not yet.
No, he's 1-4.
Ah, okay, that's right. I forgot.
He's got one level in Barbarian for the Raging. That misses. That hits. And then he actually... Alright.
That'll end his turn.
Okay. Which brings us to Ogrek.
The useless NPC.
Yeah, we all think our NPCs are fucking garbage.
Except mine.
What's for yours? What's yours do?
Mine's an actual soldier.
You rat bastard.
Fucking, I have essentially what is kind of useless to us as our for our initial actions for everything are kill it quickly, kill it fast, kill it now.
She gonna shoot this one.
Okay,
that's all she can do.
Well, at least she hits. I think someone in my dorm, on my floor has the same type of TV as me, because they just turned off and on my TV a couple of times. It's like, God damn it. This You're brings haunted. Us to Aoife. It better not be fucking haunted.
I used to do that back in my old college. It's just, I had I'm a university remote. We programmed all the TVs in the student area.
Alrighty. Well, because I don't feel like utilizing a spell slot, I'm going to use my channel divinity, and I'm going to grant 15 hit points to Serac and 15 hit points Horseman. 15.
So you're only level 5.
He rode on his back literally an hour ago.
That was last week.
Literally an hour ago.
And then bonus action, taking my spiritual weapon. I honestly don't remember who it was sitting next to. But fuck it, we'll strike this wolf here. Assuming it's somewhere there.
Okay.
Spiritual load weapon.
Nice.
That hits.
Alrighty. That's her turn.
Okay, and then that would bring us to Serac.
Yeah. And let's see.
I'm gonna kill this giant right now. I can't do that.
I honestly don't care if this breaks his character. He's going to disengage and GTFO because this is obviously a bit much for him. He's gonna hide behind the 9-year-old girl.
That's a smart play.
Because, you know, she's wearing heavy
armor. And that's his turn?
Yep.
Okay, that brings us to Jid.
Okie dokie. Jid is going to lance this one. Then he's going to, because of dual wielding, he's going to longsword it. And then extra attack, he's going to longsword it again.
Nice.
Yep, that all hits.
Okie dokie. That's the end of his turn.
Okay, then Maxwell. Okay.
Advantage. And sharpshooter going to attempt the short bow.
On which one?
Most damaged one at the front. Outside the gate.
Outside the gate, okay.
So only the 22 hits.
Oh, yeah.
And that's all he's going to do. So Duvessa is going to try to attempt to, I don't know, intimidate or persuade, whichever one, the giants and yell in giant, "Your leader is dead. I suggest you retreat now, considering we brought down the strongest of you."
Okay, make a persuasion attempt. Nope.
He sucks. He officially sucks. That was her action. So I can't have her run away. Because that would risk a attack of opportunity from Wolf Boy over there. And
no, she's not adjacent to the wolf.
Oh, sweet. I'm gonna have her try to get behind Zeus at that point.
Come on. Okay. Which brings us to him.
Zeus is going to moon. Wait, hold on. Moonbeam would be his next turn, which is next. So, Moonbeam. This one. I will post the stuff in the chat. Yeah, and that would be, wait, that's the wrong character sheet. I have 3 character sheets open, all right, y'all?
It's all good.
Yeah, that would be it for his turn.
Sorry, which one were you targeting?
This one.
That one, okay.
So it,
oh, wow.
It looks like it would take the damage initially, because it says when a creature enters the spell's area for the first time or starts its turn there.
Yeah, and it's going to, and there's an NPC between, so I'm just going to roll the save now. And what is it?
DC 16.
And it's Constitution. it's half as much. Okay.
All right, and so Baltic is going to swing at this one with a maul.
Mm-hmm.
And that will be it for my turn. What?
Bartek, you're the best NPC of all of them. Mark, his word of God.
No, I'm not going to lie. I thought you were going to stop at, you know, Zeus is going to moon him.
Yeah, no, that's what I was like, I wasn't ready for you to show elephant ass.
All right.
I wasn't.
In retaliation, Zeus gets a rock thrown at him. It fucking misses, though. Just goes over his shoulder and crashing into town.
Would I hit Duvessa?
He's like,
no, it did not hit Duvessa.
He just moved, like, steps to the side a little bit.
Yeah, and then the one that is being threatened by four is going to swing once at Vegeta and once at Jid. So after resistance, Vegeta takes 10 damage, and Jid takes 16. Winterwolf's going to move a little closer and try and bite Jid.
Damn, Jid's going to go down.
Yep, Jid, you take 9 damage of the piercing variety, and I need you to make a strength saving throw.
I am proficient in this.
All right, you pass that strength save. You're not knocked prone. The other one is going to bite. It failed to bite Mr. Sheriff Man over here. Mr. Sheriff Man is going to respond to that by swinging at him twice. First one misses, but the second one most certainly hits. All right, and that brings us to Vegeta.
Tell them.
Oh.
Hey.
Oh.
Hey.
Hello.
Hello.
It's your turn whenever you're ready.
Yep. That frost giant in front of me is going to get pummeled again, hopefully.
Okay, its health is very low, so roll your attacks one at a time.
Well, yeah. I only have one more key point, so I'm waiting to use it.
Okay, that hits but does not kill.
Use martial arts, you can do it. And if you don't do it, Jid could do it. It's fine.
Yeah, that's what's gonna happen. Just gonna do a second attack with martial arts.
Okay. That hits and knocks him dead on his ass.
Good. Now time for the skull fucking.
Thing is, you still have these winter wolves to deal with.
I'll skin them.
Then you have Ogrek. Once your turn Does that, and that's end your turn, right? For Vegeta?
Yeah.
All right, that brings us to Ogrek then. And that misses.
Shit's failed me for the last goddamn time.
Even if.
All right.
That would.
That's your turn.
It is Eva's turn.
All right. Well, I'm gonna come down to my favorite horseman. And
he's the only horseman.
And I get the feeling I'm gonna regret this. I'm gonna bitch slap him. Oh, thank God that worked. Okay. So we are casting Cure Wounds at third level because of that. Ha ha ha.
Just gonna double check your sheet real quick to just so I remember what spell slot you're using for that.
I'm using a second level spell slot.
That's why I thought. I need a double. So I'm going to double check that you're doing this right. Did I say round it up? I said round it down.
I said round down.
Okay. So it'll be two levels higher. It'll be two levels higher at
level 8. Five.
Level 8, yes.
Anyway, so he gets healed for 25. You're welcome.
Thank you. He has a candy ball.
Gave him a pat on the ass. Smacked him on the ass like a real horse, and he reared up like, oh shit.
Ready? And a spiritual weapon, the doggy.
The doggy.
I'm gonna keep my weapon, my comment to myself on that
misses.
One.
Dang. Alrighty. And then that brings it to Cirac's turn. And he's just going to throw a dart.
Nice.
At the doggy?
Yeah.
Okay, that hits.
Yeah. That doggy.
And that ends?
That ends.
Which brings us to Jid.
Jid will attack this one with a lance.
Okay, hit.
Then a longsword when it decides to come up.
Hit.
And another longsword.
And still a hit. Jesus, the damage output. maybe I've been sleeping on fighter this whole time. Like I've never played a fighter.
Dude, fighters are insane.
Especially when I have a 20 to my strength.
Yeah, I think my next character needs to be a fighter. Next I'm a player. And then that brings us.
Yeah, that was it.
Okay, that brings us to Maxwell.
Wait, hold on. No, wait, oh. I've already did my bonus action. Never mind.
Maxwell is going to hide. I shouldn't have been
stealthy.
28 shall do it.
Yep.
And
yeah, if you accidentally roll with advantage or disadvantage when you don't have it, just take the first roll.
I don't know if I should use a pepper box or the short bow right now. I'll save the pepper box for the wolf if it's still there. And without sharpshooter this time. Because I don't want to risk missing it because it looks like it's low on health. So, without sharpshooter, I'm going to short bow. Wow. I'm very glad I chose not to do sharpshooter.
On which one? This one? That misses.
Yeah, I figured.
That was a really good roll, but it missed.
Yeah. Garbage.
Oh, I hear shit from you, Hatter.
No, it wasn't anything you did. It was something I read and a comment you made earlier that popped back in my head.
Well, please share with
about us. About the moonbeam.
You just realized this?
No, hold on. I also have the spell Gust of Wind. I'm going to leave that there.
Yes.
Yeah, I don't sleep on druids. I've just never played one, and I didn't realize they get all the good spells. Because I know that they get Call Lightning because
you're a lightning.
They're the only one. Because I'm a lightning fanatic and I love lightning. Jesus Christ, someone's got a fucking nuke.
And Duvessa is going to throw a dagger at the doggy.
Okay. Her only dagger, and it misses.
Yep. She ain't gonna do shit with it. Might as well throw it.
Right, which brings us to Zeus.
Zeus is going... Oh, this doesn't do damage, it's just bushes. I was totally about to do Gust of Wind, but I was like, no, it doesn't do damage.
Yeah, great spell. Doesn't do damage.
Yeah, but it would have been totally worth it for the context earlier.
Yes.
Yeah, for a fart. For the fart joke, yes.
For the fart joke.
You shall not.
Okay, so I will do Erupting Earth at third level. It's my last third level spell slot.
Which one?
This one.
Okay.
And I will tag the thing.
20-foot cube, okay. So, just this one though, right?
Yes.
Actually, considering that this is large and this is huge, you could hit them. You could hit both.
Hit both wolves?
Yep.
Okay.
Because they're only that distance. Because they're only the distance of the thing apart. Because they were doing adjacency. And it's what con dex. Okay. All right. Roll the damage. Or did I miss it? Oh, I did see it. Okay, there you go. Jesus. Yeah, roll the damage. That's not damage. That's the game shitting on you. Can you roll damage for me?
What is damage?
It's 3d12.
You rolled a 5. That is the game
taking a
big shit on your roll.
Yeah, that's the game taking a dump on your ass. That's 3d12. You should... There we go. There
that's
we go.
3d12
right There's there. Some real damage. There's some real damage. Just fucking up. That's a fucking apology. That's a fucking apology. You absolutely murder one.
And it's set right, too. It says 3d12 damage type. Bludgeoning.
Yep.
Wow.
And then additionally. Just checking. Okay, it's just the damage and difficult terrain, but the damage is what's important.
Yeah.
Yeah, so you kill one of them, and the other one is not having a good day. Which brings us to... You have...
This one.
Sir, what's his face, right?
Yep. I'm going to move him over here to this one, and he is going to maul him.
And that hits. And kills.
Woo! Yay!
And
Zeus can get a dangerous combo.
Then I need you to roll damage from Moonbeam.
Because
that's a concentration spell, right? And you didn't break concentration.
As far as I'm aware, I thought I rolled damage from Moonbeam. Or do I have to roll it again?
You rolled it again.
Okay, 1 minute.
Because when a creature, because it's every time that it does it.
Swear to God, if V6 starts singing Ain't No Love of My Man, who up, I'm going to fucking cry.
Ooh, that's actually really close. I actually have to fucking roll it.
No, I'm sorry. It's just this song. Me and
it
my,
fails.
Me and my coworker found this song the other night. Like, it popped up on my YouTube playlist. And I have to share it with y'all. I have
to. All right, and that is all of them.
This is the song that is playing in Aoife's head right now.
All right. So, I'm just going to... I'm just gonna roll up the treasure right now because yes.
I'm going to walk over to the vessel and say,
and
I apologize for how I was acting earlier. It's just you.
He took a quarter of a quarter to give him a quarter for every quarter of a quarter chucked. The woodchuck song. I'm faking. Put some bass on that. It's not a song. It's a fucking tongue twister. How much would you woodchuck?
Yes, they made a song out of it. Get ready for the woodchuck song. How much
would the woodchuck chuck if a woodchuck could chuck wood? Wait, this bangs, bro.
Right?
Yeah, why is it a banger?
Like, why is it banging so hard, though?
Okay, so... As a distraction while I'm rolling out the loot, you guys are level 6 now.
Why is this banging so hard?
I'm gonna stop it before I get flagged for copyright again.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, I got flagged for copyright when we played a Stairway to Heaven.
I told you. I told you.
Why did that bang so hard, though? That doesn't make sense.
It's an amazing song.
Yeah, that should not have banged that hard.
Why is that so good? Also, I get expertise now. I get another set of expertise. That's okay. Great. I'm going to put it into persuasion just to spite Dubessa.
Oh, crap.
Just to spite her.
All right. And because the battle is over, you guys actually no longer have control of these NPCs.
Yay. We kept them alive.
You kept them alive.
Thieves' tools, sleight of hand, insight, or perception. Or deception. I'm getting persuasion only.
Perception is good. Persuasion. One.
Only to spite Dubessa. Only. Solely to spite her. Yeah. Dubessa, I'm truly sorry. If there's anywhere I could take you out for a drink afterwards. And what makes you think I would want to have a drink with you? I can be very persuasive.
Oh, I have to be a half.
Fine. How do you do that? Better than you in every fucking way.
So I have a question.
Yes.
Yes.
Are we allowed to go beyond 20, or do we have to stay at 20 as the cap?
You can go beyond 20. I think that the cap is bullshit, so you can go beyond 20. Yeah, anytime you're in anytime I'm DMing, the cap is merely a suggestion.
So now I have beaten Dubessa in body and mind at this point.
Why are you beating women? Didn't your mom teach you not to be an abusive asshole?
No.
Well, shit.
I never finished leveling up fucking Boris. Oh my god. Get you a level up, my guy. I should have finished your level up. My bad, bro. Mother.
Did you guys see that?
None. Hit or
You weren't supposed to see that.
I didn't see it.
I saw everything.
You're
can
fine.
I go?
Okay.
Get a feat of mountain combat.
Ooh, ain't no love for my man.
Six levels of speed, Pete, right?
Yeah, you get a feat. Regardless of how many regardless of how many levels you have in your classes, you'll get a feat, but because it's not built for that, you have to do it manually. Oh, perfect.
So character Mancer just took a shit right now for Boris's level up and just gave me 10 HP for some reason. Like, it's like instead of like having the average of know what I should have, it just gave me 10. And I'm just like, why are you doing this to me?
Yeah, like, it did the same thing to me. Oh crap.
Let's roll a D8 and see what happens.
You know what? I'm just going to do the stuff that's worth gold.
Did I actually gain?
That's a 3. Use? That's below average. I'm taking 5.
Oh!
There's no I'm point totally in rolling doing this. I know you're just going to fucking sell them.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Alright, there's the... there's the treasure.
Where? Oh, Jesus Christ. We're taking
at 6th, none of at 6th level.
6th level, when I'm in my beast form, when I'm in my beast shape forms, all of my damage does counts as magical damage for the sake of resistances.
Nice.
Also, spells. I can learn up to 11. I can add up to 11 spells.
What did I get? I got a 6.
How do I have 12 spells?
What's the average? I forgot what the average is.
Not me there.
Be fine.
Wait a second, why the hell does she not have this yet? She clearly needs
underwear to be there. Because we're gonna get something else. Gonna get... should I get Revivify? I feel like I should get Revivify.
Hold on. I think there's something wrong with Zeus's sheet. I only know... How many cantrips is a druid supposed to know?
I don't know.
At 6th level?
Let's see. If you include your circle spells, 7?
Oh, crap.
Why? How many do you have?
It only registers 2. And that's all I've been using. And it's not letting me add any more.
Huh.
It might be because I'm using a UA.
Might be.
And I might have to manually add them.
Let's level up funny. Selena while we're at it.
No, it's funny.
I know a lot of
Max. All right, just let me know when y'all are finished leveling up. Because I've got
and
make sure that you have all the benefits of a long rest. Because yes, because you fucking leveled up. You get a long rest when you level up. That's how it fucking works. You actually, well, rules is written. You need to take a long rest to level up. But I'm gonna say it the other way around. When you level up, you get long rest.
That's 1,050. Gold pieces between all of us.
I'm gonna have to do this manually on Zeus, so we can go ahead and continue, but I gotta do this stuff manually.
I'm currently dividing shit right now. So divided by 1, 2, 3. 4. Am I dividing Aoife into this too?
Aoife gets an allowance.
Yeah, that's right. She does get an allowance. I'll give her 10 of my gold. She that I get from this. Each of us is counting Zelena.
Yep, make sure to split the part, split the loot amongst any party members that might be, that are potentially in the next session. That's what I'm going to say.
Actually, just
anyone that has potential to be in the next session.
I am going to, just, if I wanted to get Boris something, I'm just going to take it out of Maxwell's gold.
Yeah, that's fair. It's two of your characters. Oh.
But all of the adult party members save for
six level
Aoife, because she's not an adult.
Okay.
Get 210 gold.
Okay. Yeah. Zeus's sheet is good, and I think it's because of the UA stuff.
Yeah, once you start using the fucking homebrew stuff, it gets to the point where it's like, no.
Yeah, because I'm looking at my cantrips outside of Character Mantle, and I have three cantrips, and it says I'm supposed to have three cantrips. And then four level one spells. Which
yep. And then druids are preparation casters, so you can just have, so the number you can prepare is your level plus your charisma mod, not charisma, for you it's wisdom. There isn't a fucking prep charisma caster. What the fuck am I on?
So yeah,
I didn't mean to do that.
The amount of money everyone should have.
Then
aside
we
is 210. 210.
And then I'm supposed to loan three level three, so I have to add one level three. So I have to find a level three spell.
I would like to buy.
Well, those are just your slots. That it should say.
Oh, slots.
Because the number of spells you can have prepared is equal to your level in the class.
But druid.
Plus your wisdom modifier.
Druids and clerics and whatnot have access to all their spells.
Yes, and they just decide what they have prepared. After a long rest. Now, it's actually a lot simpler in 5e. In 3.5e, you had to decide how many uses of each spell you would have access to.
Oh, right. I should probably choose a feat. I forgot about that for a second.
Yes. Yes, and you're going to have to add it manually.
Yeah. So, I just decided to refresh my page because it was lagging behind really bad. And when it loaded back into the wrong campaign.
Yeah,
it does that sometimes.
I was just looking at it going, wait a second. That's not right.
Yeah. I imagine so.
Like, why are all of my DM notes in here?
Maybe because it thinks you're the DM. Because you're in a different campaign. Game said no. So we got a glimpse. So viewers will be getting a glimpse of the new stuff.
Oh, wow. So I can have 11 spells prepared. Yeah, my thing's all scooty.
Yeah, it's screwy even for... I noticed it was screwy even for normal. Like even for non-homebrew characters. In terms of giving you spells.
I know Fighter, it's pretty easy.
Yeah, Fighter's easy, because it's Fighter.
Come on. Give me my character sheet. There we go. Damn.
Yes.
Anyway. Give me this one. Beauty. So, just so everyone's aware, Zelina has taken the resilient feat. So, she got one ability score increased by one, and now has proficiency in saving throws with that ability.
Constitution?
Dexterity.
Dexterity, okay. I would have thought that as a wizard, you would have gone with Constitution.
She's already got a 16 in Constitution.
I have to choose a feat for Boris, too. Damn it.
Yep. I'm not going to lie to you. I'm playing Fallout while I wait for you guys to finish your level ups. Just
playing Fallout? Seriously?
Yeah, I like Fallout. And I'm going to put it down once anyway, you guys are ready.
How much gold was Aoife given for her allowance?
I'm giving her 10 of my gold. I'll give her 30.
30 gold?
30 gold. Yeah, I'm giving her 30 gold from me, from Maxwell.
He's a rich kid. And Zelina got how much? Was it
210? She got 210, yeah. Along with the other adults in the party.
210?
Yeah, 210.
Okay.
I'm still looking through feet because I don't know what to choose for... Oh, drow high magic. Learn more of the magic, typical dark elves. Detect magic, and cast it at will. So I can also learn levitate and dispel magic. Ooh, that's good. That's good. That's good. That is good.
Let's see. Oh, sweet. So now, whenever Aoife casts a healing spell, she heals herself as well.
Cool.
Oh yeah, that level 6
yep.
Life cleric.
Ooh, but mobile would be great.
Regain hit points equal to 2 plus the spell's level. Every time I cast a leveled spell. Or a leveled healing spell.
Which... That's pretty, that's not like the best, but that's still pretty decent.
Speaking of, I now have to go through all my healing spells and make sure they're still. Still got my stuff at a
magic or mobile? That is the question. Where does fade away? I'm curious about that. Wait a second. Oh, wait, that's no. Okay, I can't get that. Oh, so that would be so dope. Okay, draw high magic or mobile, guys.
I would probably go with mobile.
Yeah, well, go with what would be more appropriate for the character. Like, because while it's cool and you're able, would it be appropriate?
Crap, I forgot to take another feat for Zeus.
He would get detect magic, levitate, and dispel magic.
And I gave Aoife a healer, so we're going to need to buy her a medicine kit, or a healer's kit.
Okay, how much is that?
I don't know.
It's like 10 gold. It's very cheap.
Buy her a healer's kit.
There it is.
Is there any way I can gain proficiency with said healer's kit.
There are ways to gain proficiency. When you have a lot of downtime, you'll be able to train.
Why the fuck did it put my speed to 10? It should be plus 10, shouldn't it? So I should have 40?
Yeah, they messed up when they did that. Come on.
Oh.
No, not select. We're not selecting text here. We're trying to drag and drop.
Where do I change?
There we go.
Where do I change the thing? The fucking speed.
Speed?
Popping up over here.
Try searching. Like, so click on the gear by the page turning by where you turn your pages.
I'm there.
Look for speed.
It's tracking my armor class, but where is my speed? Attribute options. This is not there, I don't think. I'll just change it manually. So I now have 40 speed.
Round 20 is acting up today. I don't know what it is.
Make a melee attack against a creature you don't provoke from that creature for the rest of the turn. Whether you hit it or not. Sweet. Okay, well, that's good. Okay, now I have to drag Boris onto the thing so I can drag. So I can drag fucking stuff. Fucking feats for him over there. Alright, what am I getting, Boris?
Alright. Now I just need to find one feat, and then Zeus will be done. It's another good feat for Zeus. An AO code. An AO code. An AO code.
I'm already ritual casting, so that's useless to me.
I'm ready.
Give me a second.
How many feet are you supposed to have at level 10? You're supposed to have, what, 2 or 3?
See, at level 10, you said?
I mean, at level 6.
At level 6? So, with 6 levels, so you should have 2 extra feats on top of what you would get rules as raw. Rules as raw. Rules as written.
So you're supposed to have 3 basic feats.
Yeah, you should have...
If we can roll 20.
2 or 3.
I only have 2 basic feats. Everything else is part of my class.
Did you take an ASI or a feat at 4?
Like an ASI.
Okay, so if you took an ASI, you should only have 2 feats.
What's an ASI?
an ability score increase.
Oh, yes.
So if you increase one of your ability scores at 4, then you don't need to have, then you only have 2 feats.
Okay, so yeah, that is correct. I just wanted to make sure.
It's all fine. It's all good.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, everything's right now. Okay. These two are done.
Okay.
Benefits of a long rest.
Guys.
We're listening.
Yeah.
So... And look at it too. Fuck. Damn it all.
Damn you all to hell.
I was literally looking.
Who else are we waiting on?
Me.
Kushida's done.
Okay, then we are just waiting on...
Me?
Yep.
The other monk.
The other druid, really.
Well, yeah, and this one.
A resilient or athlete, guys.
That... they're both good feats. I think overall resilient will be. It depends. Are you trying to have this character last forever, or are you trying to have this character do great things?
I know both, but also
I just Russian.
So
Russian.
I just know what.
Okay. So for Russian, I would say resilient.
Resilient?
Because Russians are tough motherfuckers.
I'm just happy Zeus and Jid now move at the same speed.
Did they not before? Oh, wait, never mind. They didn't before because...
I took a feat. I took... Zeus is mobile. Which I'm kind of debating about putting on Zeus, but Zeus has the charger. I'm going to roll for it. Even it stays, odd to change.
Honestly, I don't think there's 4 more feats that I would want to put on my characters. Like,
yeah.
It stays.
That's, if you want to find homebrew feats, I'd recommend that.
Wait, what about homebrew feats?
If you find homebrew feats that you would like. Like, if you find a homebrew feat you want, just swing it by me and I might let you take it.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
If you guys are ready, I'm ready.
All right, we were just waiting on you.
I'm ready.
So after the battle, Sir Beric approaches Zeus and begins to ask of him a favor. He is currently tracking down A wanted criminal named the Cerberic is the one you were controlling, Zeus, right?
Yes. Oh yeah, okay.
Yeah, Cerberic. And he's determined to chase down a wanted criminal known by known as the Weevil.
Weevil.
And he thinks, but he's beginning to fear that the trail has gone cold. He's going to remain in town for a couple days before searching elsewhere. And he doesn't want you guys to chase after him. He's asking you to go report to his superiors what he's doing. So he suggests that you seek out Sir Lanover Strail, a devout follower of Tyr, who lives in Neverwinter.
Is it Neverwinter in Neverwinter? I feel like this is a valid question that nobody is taking the time to ask.
I am typing notes. Give me a second.
Well,
yes, I take notes. Oh.
Ah, the negotiator.
And what am I supposed to inform Sir Lavis to?
Cerberic is asking you to inform Cerberic that two fucking knights, and I don't really deal with knights. So he's suggesting that you inform, that you report that Cerberic is continuing to chase down the Weevil. Like, he just wants you to go to Neverwinter and report.
Okay. Done. My notes are taken.
All right. Whether or not you actually go and do that is up to you. And then, do you guys have any plans to spend your newfound riches in town?
I've already decided on buying a healer's kit. I've already done so and added it to my inventory.
Okay.
And I just got resilient in the fucking Boris's character sheet.
Unfortunately, I don't have enough gold for what I want.
That is unfortunate.
What do you want?
What, yeah, you could.
To get that is so expensive.
You can appeal to other party members to pull your money together.
What do you need?
Braces of defense.
Wait. Oh. Who's asking for what? I'm very confused.
Vegeta is looking for bracers of defense, apparently.
Oh.
How much do those cost?
A lot.
That depends on who's selling them.
They cost a lot, no matter who's selling them.
Yeah.
1,000 gold is base price.
Personally, I wanted to see if I could get a better bow than what I have.
Don't you have a gun?
I do have a gun, but I want a bow because all of the damage I've done has come from the bow.
Have you even used the gun yet?
I haven't.
I can't afford what Jed wants.
So how much money did you guys take?
200.
It was two.
Yeah, we each have 210.
So you should have
added up
to
So assuming so I just double checked your math, and assuming that you just sell everything.
Mm-hmm.
Is that what you're going to do? Sell everything?
Yeah.
Okay. So. You would each get 350.
No. I did terrible math, guys. Never stop trusting me with math. Jesus.
Don't worry. I'm good with math. So if you guys need someone who is good at throwing numbers into a calculator, I can do that.
Calculator, schmalculator. That's an extra 140.
I mean, yes, an extra 140.
Okay. Yeah, it's still not enough for what Jid would like to have.
Yeah, that's fair.
Jid, all only thing Jid wants is like heavy armor. Like he wants to go full plate. Which increases his AC to 18.
How much is full plate?
It's like
1500.
Yeah, it's 1500. Okay.
Oh shit.
Yeah, full plate.
Is yeah. Yeah, I have chainmail right now.
And honestly, with Jid being a centaur, it might be even more expensive because you might have to buy horse armor.
No, I wouldn't make him buy horse armor. No, that would be punishing him, not. And punishing players isn't what I'm about.
I will be right back.
You're good. Let's see. I should choose. What things I want for Boris to be better with in his ability scores.
So it sounds like you guys are going to need more money before you can do your shopping shenanigans.
I mean, I could still probably get something that I want, maybe, perhaps. I just want a bow, man. I want a better bow.
You want a better bow?
I want a better bow. Yes, I have a gun, but, like, that gun is only good for so much. I want a bow, man.
Well,
let's see what type of bow I could get. Like, what kind of bow?
The only thing you could get better would be outside your price range.
How far outside of its price range?
Ooh, maybe I could get silvered arrows.
Oh yeah, silvered arrows. You can, in fact, get silvered arrows. Oh, what's the price for that?
Because that would be great, because that just ignores resistances for stuff like undead and shit, so.
Yeah, that'd be good if you encounter any shapeshifters, because those typically. Here we go. You can silver a single weapon or 10 pieces of ammunition for 100 gold pieces.
100 gold pieces for 10 things of ammunition? Jesus.
Oh, well, you're actually paying only for the price of silver as well as the weapon.
Well, it's the price of the silver and the time and expertise needed to add the silver to the weapon without making it less effective.
Damn. I don't want to waste all 300 gold. I could just two sets and still have 100 gold left. I'll still have 180 gold left, but you know, whatever. How much is a quiver of arrows? Let's find out. I would course, too. Like, I have a quiver, right? I should have a quiver.
Wait, Renaissance bullets? I have a gun, too. I could also get fucking bullets.
Oh, are you looking at the Renaissance table in the DMG?
I'm just looking at 5e tools and what I could get, but yeah, essentially. Can I see how much I could get for arrows? What I need to pay for arrows. Mm-hmm. 20 arrows for one gold piece. I could get essentially 40 arrows for 2 gold pieces.
Yep.
It's 60 for 3. So I'll get 60 arrows, which would put me at 377. And then that puts me at, I'm just going to say 78. Arrows
coming at me. Here we go.
And then,
yeah, okay.
$100 per 10 pieces of ammunition. 100 gold per 10
to silver, ammunition. 10 pieces of ammunition.
Yeah.
And you could buy, and of course you could theoretically buy pre-silvered ammo for the price of the ammo plus 100 gold. So yeah, you could use the what's it called? The weights and cost of bullets from for the Renaissance bullets. That you found on 5e tools, because those are just from the DMG.
So I'm gonna silver 20 arrows. That's gonna
put okay. me to
177. Silver and 20 arrows.
That's neat. All right, are we ready to rock and roll?
I am ready.
I think Zeus or Adder went to do something, and I don't remember. But also, how much is a Renaissance bullet? I need to see so I can get some more of that. Also, how much is gunpowder?
So you would just are you trying to use it for something that isn't loading your gun?
No.
Okay, so you can just assume that when you buy bullets, you'll have enough gunpowder for every shot. So whenever you take a shot, you assumedly would have the right amount of gunpowder for it.
Okay. 3 gold pieces. For 10. 3 gold pieces for 10.
I am back.
All right. Is everyone here?
I'm gonna get 20 musket bullets. So
okay,
that's gonna put me down to 171, and I have now 40 musket balls.
I just realized Jid on his tools has a land vehicle.
Oh yeah, soldier.
He's proficient in rolling those land vehicles, maybe.
Well, the next time yes. Get those natural ones out of the way right now. So once the next time that the party reconvenes, you're approached by Sirak of Suzale, the character Efo was controlling.
Oh boy.
And he confesses that he's the son of the guy that those frost giants were looking for. And he thinks that they're after his magic ring of winter.
Wow. That's
interesting. Which is, let's see.
If we bring that ring to Neverwinter, will the city be renamed Winter?
Aoife?
He doesn't know.
Aoife, what did we say?
What he does know is that it's something that is very important to these these frost giants very much want it.
Probably because it has the word winter in its name.
Probably.
Ice giants have this thing for cold things. Don't ask me how I know this. It's just, I'm smarticle.
Maybe it's in the name.
Wow. Wow, Aoife. You're so good at deducing that. Slow clap. Slow clap.
Yes, all the smarticles.
You've been reading your books, haven't you?
All the ones that I could make out the funny letters in.
Rubs her head. She's just adorable, isn't she? Aoife, go ask Jid if you can ride on his back again.
Okay.
Yeah, the Ring of Winter is a strong artifact. It doesn't fucking tell me what it does, because, spoiler, you won't be able to find it.
I would like to imagine that Sirak is now feeling like an idiot because he cowered behind this girl who clearly is a fucking idiot during this fight with the giants. Just, I hid behind that.
So, Sirak doesn't know his father's current whereabouts, but he does know that he had connections to a noble family in Waterdeep called the Roaring Horns. He's asking you to visit their estate in Waterdeep and speak to someone there. And he's goddamn afraid that frost giants might come after him again because of the blood ties he has to his father. And he's offering to accompany you as far south as Luskan, which is a city in the south. Surprise. I don't know. Do I have a map for Luskan? No, I don't have a map for Luskan, so you won't be doing any fighting in there. He wants to flee. He wants to get the fuck out of there. He wants to get as far away as he can. So he's gonna hop on a ship in Luskan and head south and head even further south.
Listen up like a bitch, are you? On your way then.
Doesn't say that to him. Should note that. Says that in his head, but doesn't say that to him.
So So we're going to Neverwinter, Waterdeep. Where's next? The Somerset Isles?
Excuse me, sir. Where exactly is Duvessa?
I feel like this is like out of Spyro.
Yeah, right?
She agreed to meet me at for a couple of drinks.
Well, we'll assume that this happened after that, but during your drinking session, your supposed whatever you thought it was.
Drinking.
You're drinking.
He needs a glass of wine. Jesus Christ. He is drinking. He's been with a horseman, an elephant man, and two childlike adults. And an actual child this entire time. He needs a fucking drink.
Well, in addition to your fucking drink, Duvessa presents you with a letter that she tells you that she sent a letter to her aunt, Minerva Coldwater, the captain of a ship called the Dancing Wave, saying that, basically asking her to provide passage and accommodation to y'all if they need travel up or down the Stored Coast.
Much appreciated, man. And sorry for calling you useless on the battlefield.
Presents you with a copy of that letter in case the letter got lost in transit.
That is very much appreciated. Again, so sorry for freaking out on you in the middle of the battlefield. You just weren't doing much. Turned away and leaves.
I mean, it was all stressful, so it's understandable.
Are we not gonna be traveling with Mr. Hill Giant again? Is he Cloud Giant? Mr. Big Guy.
Yeah, no, he's gone.
Aww.
Like once he dropped you off, he said he was going back where he was studying, and he fucked off. He thinks you guys. He's convinced that you guys are gonna take care of things, and he was very confident in. You guys gave him a boost of confidence and eased his tension, eased his worries by showing up.
Okay, lads. Let's see. I have 20 silvered arrows.
Have you met me? I'm me.
44 bullets for the gun that I still haven't used. Have a letter for ocean travel. Feel like we're missing something.
So, this captain of the Dancing Wave is also in Waterdeep.
Well, it looks like we're going to Waterdeep first, then.
Yeah, if you need passage anywhere up or down the coast, it's been secured for you by your effort, by you guys helping to clear the town of its threat, of the threat to it. And
oh, my lord.
What?
I was looking for just like a gif to put in the chat, you know, with what Jid was doing. You know, like just prancing around a little bit. And I came across this.
Came across what, man? Oh, my goodness. Why? Why is this a thing? Why did he look at the camera Furries. Like we caught him in something?
You know what's sad?
Furries,
the only thing I look... Yes. I only search horse and the GIF search. That was it.
Alright.
That is not what Jed is doing.
Are you sure? The viewers yes, have to I'm see sure. this. The viewers have to see this. In all of its glory.
Stop that. You stop that. Don't do that to them. I may be rude to them, but I'm not that evil.
So there's
if I had to witness it, so did they.
No, they don't. Folks, if you're still watching
Jared
before he puts this on the screen, don't look.
Dude, you're far too late.
Okay.
Terrible mind. Honestly,
I have to say this is. I'm gonna say that, and I'll post it here in a moment.
So you guys are ready to decide on a quest and head out?
Yes.
It seems there's to do in Waterdeep, apparently. Seems there's more shit to do in Waterdeep.
Waterdeep.
Wait, what about the closing person who, Vegeta was controlling? She's useless.
Vegeta had Cerberic, right?
No,
Ogrek.
Ogrek. Oh yes, I have something. She's done. Yes, she'll. Yes, when you leave town, she's kind of got a job to do, so she's not seeking out the adventurers.
Oh. Yeah, I can see Jid doing this.
Yes. And this is what happens when Jid rolls an at one on a charge.
Yeah. I'm clear up the turn order.
Plains, winter tundra. Well, Boris doesn't have any problems with the winter tundra. He grew up in the D&D equivalent to Russia, so...
Well, no, I was just posting those because that's the off of Spyro 2 Ripto's Rage. Those were the home worlds.
Yeah. Anyway, I would think we have more stuff to do in Waterdeep than we do in the other places. Although the significance of what we have to do in the places is also a factor. So.
Well, the only thing we have to do in Neverwinter is say, hey, just so you know, this guy is still hunting this guy.
How far away is Neverwinter from here?
That is what I am trying to figure out.
Okay.
Here we go. Alright, I'm showing you guys a map. It's going to be called Random Wilderness Encounters, but it's just you guys just see a map. So Neverwinter.
That's a lot.
It is a big map. So you guys.
Neverwinter is along the coast. So Neverwinter is right here. Ah.
Neverwinter is right there. It. Then and you guys are in Bryn Shander.
Bryn Shander is. That's not a coastal city, is it?
No, it is not. It's pretty much a straight shot north. Like northwest. Or it's,
I got it.
If you follow the tangent of the coast, you'll see it.
Yeah, I see it. Wow.
Let me whip out a ruler real quick to see how many miles you'd be traveling. Because, like, I'm not
it's
able to...
It's more than 24 hours, isn't it?
Significantly more. Yes.
Okay, I can't use that. That's what I was going to wonder. I
can't use what?
Do animal messenger, but it's over 24 hours.
Yeah.
Yeah. No. We will be.
I was just gonna be like a couple. I'll send a rabbit or something. Like, tell him because it's gonna be like the voice of Zeus is gonna come out of this rabbit.
That would be funny.
Boris would like to interject on that.
Oh. And let's see. Where is Waterdeep?
It's even further south.
Also along the coast. So we could hop by Neverwinter on our way to Waterdeep.
Wait, we're supposed to be hunting somebody? Or somebody is supposed to be hunting somebody else?
No,
for
I'm
crimes?
Just supposed to like give a message.
Okay, No. He informed you, you are letting that guy... So that guy is chasing... a criminal down, and he wants you to let his superiors know that that's what he's doing.
Well, I was just gonna say that, like, I could probably give them a better lead because I have criminal contact, so I would know shit. Because I'm a fucking spy and shit.
Oh, you're a spy? Do you know super cool spy moves?
Even Vegeta can
keep that on the low down.
Heritage to relay the message.
Aoife, this is between you and me. You can't tell anyone, okay?
Can you teach me some super cool spy moves?
Of course. First, you have to learn how to flip a knife through your hands. Yep.
You do remember, like, Aoife's, as far as I'm aware, still on Jid's back. And Jid's mm-hmm. still prancing around.
Yeah, no, he was just walking behind you.
Where the hell?
You know, the most dangerous place to be behind a horse. The most dangerous place to be near a horse.
But Jid knows you're there.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Mm-hmm. Just don't smack.
But what he's saying is, it's not just between you and Aoife if Jid is there too.
He knows, but he figures Jid is, you know, smarter than the fucking 9-year-old.
All right, fellas, I am unable to locate an actual ruler, so I'm going to be doing this janky.
And when Maxwell says you need to learn how to flip a knife between your hand, he does a fucking cool knife flip trick in between his hands, and you're just going to fucking roll a straight dex check. Yeah!
No, I found something that'll work.
Fucking bounces it off his bicep around around his neck and goes through his fingers and hands the knife to Aoife.
And she goes, okay, I got this.
Not all of the fancy stuff. I did just in between your fingers, love.
Okay.
Also, don't stop the horse.
And she throws it up, and that's really high. I think I threw it a little too hard. And with
you got it, you got it. I'll step in.
With both hands, manages to catch it. On the hilt.
Impressive.
It's 250 miles.
That's it.
But that's a straight shot, actually. You'd have to go.
So it's about 350, 400 miles.
A little bit more.
Yeah, I'm gonna measure it out real quick.
A little bit more practice, and you can do exactly what I did. Pats her on the head.
One moment. Yes.
Yeah, it's about 350 miles as the roads will take you.
Jid is gonna like turn to Maxwell for a bit, and it's like maybe a practice dagger would be better.
Yeah, I was thinking that too, until she caught it, honestly. So she'll be fine.
Jid is going to look straight at Maxwell. It's like, if I get stabbed, like, he's saying this underneath his breath.
Okay.
I'm going to
be fair. I wouldn't have let the knife hit her or you.
That was just a warning.
Perhaps.
Because that's going to start Jid.
Perhaps I should get her a toy knife, though. That's what I'll do. A toy dagger.
I'll even pay for it. If you don't.
It's my fault. I'll get it. How much would a toy dagger be?
A quarter of the price of a normal dagger.
How much is a normal dagger?
2 gold pieces.
Okay.
It would cost you, what, 5 silver?
The main reason it's like practice.
I'll just get four toy daggers.
So yeah, that's 2 gold pieces.
I'll just get 2 gold daggers, actually, because I don't want to do more math. He's gonna get all that, right. And he's gonna take the lucky dagger.
So your goal is Neverwinter?
Guess so. It's on the way to Waterdeep.
All right, so for the travel to Neverwinter, which is 350 miles, if you guys travel at a fast pace and, you know, with not exactly forcing, at a regular fast pace where you would take a -5 to passive perception because of how fast you're going, it would take you about 12 days. If you go at a normal pace, take you about 15. And if you go at a slow pace where you can sneak your way there, it'll take you 19 days.
We still have our horses, right?
Right. This is with your horses. Well, actually, no, it's not with your horses. I'm guessing. Let me double check.
I thought we left our horses behind when we hopped on the castle on a cloud.
We did.
I'm with you.
No, they were with us.
Boris would not have left.
Horse thieves now.
I can't remember what I named my horse.
Horace. But... Remember, you named him Horace.
Oh yeah, Horace. Thank you. Yeah. So Boris would not have left Horace. But also, Maxwell takes the lucky dagger from Aoife and gives her the two toy daggers and says, once you learn how to do the tricks with those, I'll give you the lucky dagger back. We might have been starting off a bit high level.
Okay.
So we don't want to do any lasting damage.
This is a good way to get her extra proficient daggers.
I don't know if that's a good or bad thing. And sleight of hand.
Yeah. Ooh, that was bad. Drops it, cuts himself. God damn it. Fuck.
Woo! I have a 0 to sleight of hand.
Wow, that's impressive.
Oh my god. Shit!
Damn it. Well, somebody caught that knife or blade edge down.
Shit! Oh, my hand. Jesus Christ.
Are you okay? Do you need heals? This man needs heals!
I'm fine. Love.
Zeus is gonna walk up to him and actually cast Cure Wounds. Just like pat him on the shoulder, just like, that's what you get for showing off.
Wasn't showing off. I was practicing. I can't continue to be good at what I do if I don't practice myself. He's going to lie to himself.
And Zeus is just going to pat him again. Okay.
Yeah, it would be. Yeah, those are taking into account your mounts because of... Yes, so those numbers, 12, 15, and 19, depending on what pace you guys choose, does take your mounts into consideration.
Currently balancing a dagger on his finger right now that just got healed. He's gonna flip it back and put it in his whatever he uses to hold daggers.
I'm just curious. Wait, that's Jed. Oh. Wait, hold on. No, that was what I called. I was like, wait a minute, did I just cast that from Jed? It's like, no.
Good job, Aoife.
Yeah.
That's actually very surprising from you, Zeus. That's actually very surprising. Oh my god.
I was just doing that to see what will really...
Oh my god.
Suddenly Maxwell feels the fool as he's now dropped two daggers in a row. And the child and elephant man are outperforming. He must make a comeback.
Well, to be fair, he got a 23 on that last one. Yes,
He made up for it.
Of course, he's going to hide now.
He's going to hide now.
That wasn't what I wanted at all. He didn't do. Why are you rolling everything other than? He's going to hide now.
I could totally make this joke, but I'm not going to.
And with that, he beats some people's passive perception. So,
well, considering our passive perception can only get up to 15,
I mean, mine is up to 17 right now. So,
that's right. You've got the you got a feat for that, don't you?
Yeah.
Well, you can get up way higher than that. You could probably get into What is it? Alert that gives you +5 to passive perception? No. There's something that gives you +5 to passive perception.
Everyone's like, where the fuck did he go?
You gain a +5 bonus to initiative alert.
Yeah. So with observant, you get +5 to passive perception. If you have 20 wisdom, that's another +5, so 10.
But also, I get expertise and shit, and I chose expertise and perception. So
expertise and perception gives double your proficiency bonus, and your proficiency bonus at level 6 is +3, right? Yes.
Yep.
So that's another +6.
That's the only reason I have 17 in perception was because I chose to take expertise and perception.
Oh my goodness, if she
It's possible to have a passive perception of 32 at level 20 with expertise and perception and max wisdom. And the observant feats.
Oh wow. Everyone rolled. Holy fuck. What is wrong with
Maxwell's so hidden, he doesn't know where he is.
He doesn't know where he is.
Some in a barrel somewhere. Where am I?
All right.
He's having existential crisis in the barrel.
So as you begin to leave for Neverwinter, heading through the southwest gate, you are stopped by Augrek Brighthelm, who is a favor to ask of you. She would like for you to meet with one or more representatives of her clan in Ironmaster and ask her clan folk to send reinforcements to Bryn Shander. She warns you that the dwarves of Ironmaster don't allow non-dwarves inside their lands, but if you travel toward Ironmaster and stand next to one of the menhirs and wait, some dwarves will eventually approach y'all. So just to make sure, so when you get there, just make sure that you announce that you're coming on behalf of Augrek.
That's a lot of information.
Where is this place? I don't see it. Oh wait, it's to the north. If it's kind of to the south of us, it's kind of more to the west.
Let's see. Let me open up.
Ironmaster? Yeah, it's like a straight shot west.
Less than 100 miles. A straight shot. Probably about...
If we walked along what appears to be this river here...
Probably, like, if you go by the roads, probably 150?
If we followed the road, we'd have to pass through Hundlestone first. Acrobatics? What are you doing?
Flipping.
Flipping?
Flipping. Flipping into flipping into view for you guys. Natural 20 still didn't beat me.
Yeah, but this is Jid we're talking about.
No, it's impressive nonetheless.
He's a horse. I wonder how a horse does a backflip.
No. Well, Maxwell, that's if I get an at one.
Maxwell jumped out of hiding onto Jid and then jumped off. Which started.
No. He startled Jid. Jid, like parkoured against some walls to see who the heck it was.
And Maxwell was standing on him like how Killua rides a horse the entire time.
And Aoife's just standing there. Oh! That was amazing!
Yeah, I don't think
I love it that...
to be happy with me.
I love it that our secondary characters that we made are like becoming our primary characters.
They're great. Zeus needs to babysit the other two is the thing.
That is
before Zeus's they blow job. Up another city.
That is like so this is meta. This is something about Jid and Zeus. Jid is like I would have to say a more of a I don't know how Aoife sees Maxwell, like more like a big brother or something.
Something like that.
Like Jid realizes that Maxwell has done wrong, but Maxwell is trying to make amends for it because of Aoife and trying to take care of Aoife. Like Jid would take a you know, would step in and be like, you don't screw with Maxwell or Aoife. Zeus, on the other hand, is looking at these two, these other two. It's like, I can't leave. I have to babysit y'all. Only I can cast silence.
You have the wholesome trio and the chaotic trio. This is all it is.
Like, look at the horseman, the dark elf, and the 9-year-old ASMR. And then it's like, look at those people.
All right, so are you guys heading to... Which location are you guys heading to first?
Is she holding a fireball up to a squirrel? What the fuck is wrong with her?
I believe we're going to Iron Master first, since it's closer.
Let's go to Iron Master.
Okay.
What is wrong with her? Why is she threatening an innocent woodland being?
You just hear echoing from the distance. If you squeak at me one more fucking time,
squeak!
followed very shortly by.
You know,
my ass is on fire.
So what?
Jin would like to buy a staff so he can just like Rafiki both of them in the head.
Rafiki, both of them in there.
I've got one you can use.
And then there's Vegeta, who we have just left out of all of this entire time.
He's the crazy uncle that we all love anyway.
He's the uncle that at the family reunion starts dancing and is like, y'all know nothing about this. This is the old school stuff right here. He starts two-stepping. He's like,
so I assume this is all occurring as you guys are traveling towards Iron Master?
Yeah.
So that's, Maxwell. You said that was 150 miles?
Maxwell's just helping Aoife.
If we took roads, if we took a straight shot through the woods, it would cut the time down to about 100 miles, to less than 100 miles.
Well.
This is just me eyeballing it, by the way, so.
Yeah, I'll fuck it. Doesn't matter exactly how far it is.
I'm trying to look cool, and I have the sunglasses on. I should be rolling these with advantage.
I'm sorry. I see. Crap! My brain just Vegeta with a freaking afro now. We said he's like the old school uncle. He says like yeah. Afro. Afro.
Yeah. Now I'm just thinking of that
Vegeta
clip from TFS. It was like, you're not black. What? I'm just saying, I expected black Goku. And what I got was dark Goku. Nega Goku. Ukog. You done? Goku is the new black.
So this is going to take... So are you guys taking the following the river, or are you guys going through the
there's a song about following the river that I can't
following the river?
No.
All right, so you'll be taking, so it'll take you 4 days to travel through the by river or along the river. You don't have a
song about following boat. The river that I can't remember right now, I swear.
Do you keep track of rations and stuff?
No. If you're in a place where the food isn't abundant enough to, if you guys are setting off on an actual expedition, I'll keep track of that. But this isn't that type.
Okay.
Okay.
Well, as riding like Killua.
Or stealthing?
Are you doing it stealthily?
No, I was just seeing what I would roll. That's
okay.
Maxwell, I was curious if Jid or Zeus could stealth at all.
All right, so about 2 hours from sunset on the first day. I shouldn't talk until I've got this actually set up.
So along the way,
something's going to happen.
Something somewhere happened. We don't know who, Max. We don't know where, we don't know when.
Something. But it's going to happen.
Maxwell's going to pull up next to Jid. And you're like, Jid, I need to ask you of a favor. Now, you know, typically I'm in the back or far away from the front line of the action, or, you know, anything, right?
Yeah.
But I cannot trust the other three. Vegeta's kind of weird. But,
I heard that. What are y'all's marching order? Are you how are you guys marching along?
Well, wherever Jid is, Maxwell is currently behind.
So Maxwell, Jid, and Aoife are probably all together because I think Aoife's still riding on the back.
Yes.
Yeah, I'll call that mountainous terrain.
But he's going to whisper into Jid's ear.
Zeus.
So as to
Zeus would be in front of Jid.
He's going to whisper into Zeus's into Jid's ear, so as to not startle.
Vegeta's love
for Aoife doesn't hear. I'm like, if anything should happen to me, I need you to promise me that you will get her out of wherever we are. Please.
Jed's gonna look back, and it's like, it's the same to you. If anything would happen to me, you need to take care of her.
Aww.
Of course.
We're expecting to die. This is so wholesome.
So, the sad part is, I actually have a very good song. Like, if something were to happen, it's like a good ambient song, and it's like, the first section of it, it would be like, someone like died, and it's like the emotional moment. But the second part is like, if someone did like divine intervention and was brought back to life.
Aoife crying over the dead body. I'm like, that's all it is.
Hold on.
Hmm.
Oh God, I just thought of the most sad thing I could ever have as a character if I die. Just reenact the fucking spider into the Spider-Verse scene with Uncle Aaron and Miles. Just, you're the best of all of us, Aoife. Die.
So, who's going to be the front man? Who's leading the march?
So no one's in front of Zeus. Zeus will be.
Okay.
Where is Vegeta, by the way?
Vegeta's in the back lollygagging.
Oh, that makes sense.
He's bored. In the back lollygagging. Oh, fuck. What the hell?
I didn't do it.
Unk.
No, I'm
Uncle,
just...
Uncle Vegeta.
I was trying to make a march nodal next to B4.
Oh, I'm on a different map than you all are.
Oh.
I'm setting something up. And I have somebody's default character. What's the word? Somebody's default token is somehow smaller than it should be. But I fixed it.
Ethan, you might want to loosen up on the grip on that horse. You're kind of choking it.
Sorry.
Maybe he likes to be choked.
Oh, no. Not Aoife. Vegeta. I don't think it does. It is turning purple right now.
Aoife. I'll put Aoife beside.
Vegeta, just because your wife left you.
Shit.
Does that mean you can choke horses?
And Maxwell behind. There we go.
Well, it's not like you're giving me anything else to choke.
Choke a chicken.
Yes.
You know what? No, Vegeta is that uncle that just got, that's fresh out of jail. Like, it changed him on the inside. Prison changed him. He was never the same afterwards.
I'm about to pop a cap in your heart. What the fuck? Vegeta, calm down. Oh, no.
Do we not have a bot chat?
We do. I just hid it from the rest of the players.
Oh.
Did you? You did. One more time.
Did you? You can still utilize his commands anywhere. You just gotta know how to use them.
Maxwell's gonna tell Aoife a story about his life, but make sure that she doesn't think it's about his life. Kinda like Kratos and Atreus when Kratos tells Atreus about the deer and the horse. Except not, you know, like that. Oh my God. Amber alert. That should scare the fuck out of me.
Eddie, who wants to draw a card?
Bet.
Vegeta will.
Alrighty, roll me a d22. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Key! Gain a major magic item!
Does that mean I can get a fucking thing and when we start the campaign again? Is that the option now?
We will consider it.
I get expertise
Okay. I need everyone to roll a perception check.
And unarmed strikes. Perception check. Wow.
Vegeta, I need you to roll a perception check.
Trying.
Shit, Maxwell and Aoife are like a happy little family, and then Zeus, Boris, and.
All right, I need anyone who rolled higher than a 12 to roll initiative.
Oh boy!
Because approaching sunset. Oh shit, I need to move you guys.
Would be nice, yes.
It would be nice. God damn it.
Approaching sunset on the first day, so we could call this dusk, party gets ambushed. Well, not really ambushed.
I rolled a 12. Oh, actually, I rolled a 7, but it ended up being a 12. I'll roll again. That is significantly better than what I had initially rolled. I'm not allowed to keep it, but I really want to.
Yeah, get that the hell out of here.
Are those cats?
I'm rolling it to put myself on the initiative board.
You're on the fucking initiative.
No, he's not.
I'm not.
No, he's not.
Yeah, he's just got a 12.
He's not on the initiative. He's not on the turn order, though.
I see him on the turn order.
We don't.
I'm not.
Oh. No.
What? Do you see Aoife and Zeus on the turn order?
Yes. Yeah.
I think it's because I rolled when you were switching the maps.
So I'll just add you in. Now do you see him?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay. Yay. It's like, what? All right. These are, well...
Yetis?
Are they kitty cats?
Anyone who wants to figure out what these are, make a nature check.
Nature? I suck at that.
So do I. I still rolled a 15.
These, these are crag cats. They're referred to in the Northlander lore as the hunter of men.
I want to befriend it.
I'm going to look at everyone and be like, there's no men here. There's no humans here.
Well, to be fair, Boris is kind of sleeping right now, but, you know.
You know, in the bag of holding.
Yeah. In the invisible bag of holding. We call it the people of holding. But to be fair, they might smell him.
This is true.
Well, they were just setting up. They just had an ambush, so.
Well, they could be smelling Jid, because Jid is half horse.
Yes, and that's delicious.
It actually is.
I'm not saying for... Oh, you horse actually tastes good?
Yes.
Oh, I did not know that.
If you've eaten glue, you've eaten horse.
Well, I'm not that dumb.
That's fucked up.
I've had elk too, so that's actually pretty good too.
All right. And then anybody who failed their perception will be added into the turn order after this round. And I need a fucking round counter. Because some of y'all have spells. Where the fuck is the options? There it is. Round.
I'm just going to need to know where, when that one that rolled a 10, a 9, or a 4 goes. Going to know which one that is. Going to need to know which one that is, because I get advantage on that shit.
You get advantage on those ones? Okay, so...
You can help with all of them.
I get advantage on those ones for one round.
There you go. Now they're all on your left.
So these ones go after Maxwell, these ones go before Maxwell. And you'll know because you'll be in fucking melee combat with two of them. Yeah. So we'll assume that Aoife is dismounted for this encounter. Wait, is that the one that's supposed to be going? That's not the one that's supposed to be going. So this Crag Cat runs up to Aoife. Because it sees the smallest one and attempts to bite her and fucking misses.
Good.
These things have... No, they don't have that, so they would be kind of on their...
This cat's not very friendly.
Yep. So another one approaches Zeus and tries to slash at him, dealing jack shit of damage. In other words, it doesn't hit. And that brings us to Maxwell.
Maxwell is going to pull out the bow, take aim, and actually reconsider and pull out the fucking gun.
Intimidation.
Tilted sideways and say, yo, motherfucker. Nah, he's not going to do that shit, but, he is going to pull out the gun, and because these things have not gone yet, I get advantage, and I'm going to aim at this middle one.
Oh, do you know this why? One. Do you know where that, the image of someone holding their gun sideways came from?
No, actually.
So, sorry for the sidetrack, but you brought it up, and I wanted to share.
Mm-hmm.
In certain models of Glock, the thing that tends to wear out the quickest is the is the thing that holds the magazine in place. So if you have a poorly maintained gun and you're firing and you're holding it properly vertically, you fire it one-handed, the magazine might, if you're holding it properly two-handed, the magazine wouldn't fall out. But if you're holding it one-handed and shooting it one-handed, the magazine might fall out after you shoot. If it's not maintained properly.
Yeah.
And because a lot of guns that gang members get their hands on are illegally obtained, it's harder to maintain them. And that tended to happen. Anyways, back to your attack.
Yep. The box. Hopefully this hits. I would assume that hits.
That does hit.
Okay. Nice. And
does not kill.
I wouldn't assume it does.
But it is in poor shape.
So, idle curiosity, it says reload 6 on it.
Yes, he can take... So it's a... It's so think of it as like... So it wasn't the precursor to the revolver. They actually were... revolvers came to popularity at the same time that the pepper box did.
Okay, so that's basically saying it's got 6 rounds before it needs to reload.
Right.
Okay.
But he could reload at any time with a bonus action. Yeah. It's a think revolver, but instead of a cylinder, it's 6 barrels.
And Maxwell is...
Ooh, that sounds fun.
It's actually pretty cool looking. I want one.
He's going to go over here next to Vegeta. There's no place to hide because this is an open field.
Yep.
Just gonna hide behind Vegeta.
I would if I could, but that is not something I can do as a drow. Halfling, sure. Or gnome, I don't remember which.
Right, and that ends your turn.
Just become my shadow.
All right, Zeus.
All right, Zeus will. This is a 20-foot square. That's not what I meant to do. Oh well, it's one too short, but whatever. I'm casting Entangled on these three.
Okay, I can actually make that right. So there, 20-foot square.
Yeah, 20-foot square.
Yeah, I've got a bunch. I found a bunch of tokens for spell sizes, but the one thing it doesn't have is a 20-foot by 20-foot square. Yep, you've got I guess you wouldn't be able to see it because you're not the one able to put assets.
Maxwell will be right here. I'm going to be honest. That's where he would have ended his turn.
All right. Mm-hmm. Set entangle. When you cast the spell, okay. And what's your DC?
DC 16.
Okay, so...
don't know why I didn't post it. And it is a concentration.
And put the cobweb one on the ones that failed. Oh wait, no, there's a net. That's easier to... so those two are restrained.
Okay, okay. And that will end his turn.
All right, so then I'm just making notes. Tangle.
The one I aimed for that is the most damage, ironically, made it out.
I don't care that I misspelled it. It's just a note. All right, this one is... the crag cat tries again and fails to escape. Brings us to this one. It's going to approach Zeus. Try to slash him with claws and miss. Then my the main one thick. Is going to attempt to break free. And he succeeds.
So does Entangle just waste their turn?
Basically, and it is difficult terrain. So it's going to stay there because it knows that running in was suicidal. So it's Aoife's turn.
Well, Aoife is going to leap off of Jid and mid-air transform into her radiant soul form.
Okay.
As her angelic wings flutter off. She is now floating in front of this giant cat. And in a newfound angelic voice, you hear her say, "Bad kitties don't get head pats." as she casts spiritual weapon down upon it.
All right. That hits. And then I need anyone who didn't. So it's Jid and Vegeta. I need you to roll initiative.
Jesus Christ, Vegeta.
Whoops, he wants to go first.
Yep, I'll just add you in manually.
Both of them go before me. I'm so happy.
Okay, that brings us to Vegeta.
Well, Vegeta is going to start this off with a little blast to... to those two.
I'm sorry? I didn't quite catch that. Oh, the Eldritch Blast. Oh, did you take...
Did you triple class?
No, I did not triple class.
Wait, how the hell do you know Eldritch Blast?
Did you take that magic initiate?
Oh,
okay, so that should actually be 2d10 because you are level 6.
Well, I'm shooting two different beams.
Oh, two different beams.
Yep, the one on the top and then the one furthest in the box to the right.
So,
left.
Wait. So this one and this one? So against the one that is So we have to make a spell attack roll for each beam. So against the one that is restrained, I believe you have advantage.
Okay.
So I'll have that first roll be for the first one.
Yeah, I'll roll for the one with advantage.
Okay, the one that you rolled without advantage hits. So roll again. All right, and that also hits.
Woo. All right, and then I'm going to run up here.
So what? All right, wait, I can just look at your sheet and see what you took. Oh, cool. Sorry, I'm just kind of looking at what you did. Oh, that's cool. All right. And is that end your turn?
No. Use my extra attack.
So, when you cast a cantrip, that uses the whole action.
Oh.
Yeah, you have to take the attack action to get extra attack.
Oh, I misread that. Okay.
Do you like the bonus action range? Seeing as I'm pretty sure a couple days are going to pass by after this fight.
Yeah, that's it then.
Okay. So this cat, unfazed.
Shit. He's currently surrounded by three shades.
Oh, okay. Yeah, the cat that is surrounded is going to swipe at Aoife again with its claws and fucking miss.
I am an angel. You cannot hurt me.
I'm going to kill that thing.
Jid is going to attack this one. Show him on the right sheet. He's going to lance it.
Okay, that then misses.
I'm close to dead because I shot it with a gun.
And then it's this one?
Yeah, this one.
Okay. The second attack hits and kills.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's the one I shot with the gun.
Alright, then I'm going to move over here and take my third swing on this one.
Okay. Wow, that hits. And does not kill. Is that end your turn?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. So then this cat will try and swipe at Zeus.
I was thinking about taking action surge.
Then Maxwell.
Due to the fact that this thing is in the middle of all of my friends, basically, I'm gonna swipe at it with a rapier. I'm gonna stab at the. Shouldn't be at advantage. I'm glad I checked that.
Damn. Oh shit, it's 3d6 for sneak attack now. Yeah, that hits and kills.
Yes. And God, I wish there was stuff to hide behind. Could I hide behind a dead body? Is that an option?
You want something to hide behind?
I just want my advantage, man.
There, that's a rock. You can hide behind that.
Gonna hide behind the rock.
Behind them.
Gonna hide behind Dwayne the Rock Johnson.
Nice. So that brings us to Zeus.
Zeus is going to... I was looking at something else and completely forgot it was about to be Zeus's turn.
That's fine.
I have Skittles.
This Skittles. Is free meat.
Going to attack that one with. I'm just going to do this mental.
Okay, that hits.
And that is it.
Okay. The top cat is going to try and break free. Which it succeeds on doing. That cat is dead. The remaining cat is going to run up to Aoife and try to slash at it with claws. Dealing 4 slashing damage.
Just messed with the little girl of the party. No one messes with the little girl of the party.
Well, it's Aoife's turn.
Well, Aoife is going to utilize her action to disengage, fly up 20 feet, and say, "Bad kitty," and swipe with the spiritual weapon.
Like I said, that hits.
Love the party.
Vegeta?
Vegeta has a quick question. Well, 2. 1.
Okay.
Are we stopping for the, like, in the game, are we stopping for the night after this? Because it's nighttime? Or are we riding through the night?
I mean, you would be stopping after this.
Okay. And this the second question.
Well, you'd be... You would keep going until sunset, and then you would stop. And your second question?
1 second.
Okay.
I've never played a monk before, so... When I attack, extra... When I use the attack action, extra attack makes me roll a second one, right?
Right, you can take a second attack when you do... The attack action. It does not, it can be against, it can be against, it doesn't have to be against the same target, just has to be against a valid target.
Which, to be fair, D&D is just about anything.
Well, it has to be in range.
How does martial arts and extra attack work?
So, together? martial arts, if you use one of your attack actions, to attack with either your unarmed strike or a monk weapon, then you can use your bonus action to attack one more time with your unarmed strike. So you can use your regular attack and your extra attack and then use your bonus action to do an unarmed strike. For a total of 3 attacks.
Okay. Well, what I was trying to figure out is does the way extra attack is worded, I couldn't figure out if it's just one extra attack because I used it, or because I used the attack action, or if it would trigger twice for each attack.
It's only for the attack action.
So, not the bonus. Okay. Thank you. Then, Vegeta is going to turn around. Rage and pummel on this kitten that just attacked Aoife.
Nobody messes with the little girl of the party.
So one, I wish there was a way to do this three times. Two,
the girl you want to eat, her older brother.
Okay.
Whoops.
Her other brother.
Well, you wouldn't have that third attack because you use your bonus action to rage, but...
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Those do kill.
Okay. Bad kid.
Girl you wanted to eat. Her uncle. Yeah.
It is Jid's turn.
Her older brother. Her other brother. That extended family that is also an elephant.
Yeah, Jid, you move right here. And he is going to attack that one. Glance it. And miss.
That missed.
Do I need to roll?
No.
Okay.
Oh my goodness, you know what I just realized?
Mm-hmm.
Another term for druid could be witch doctor. And so, we have an elephant man in our party that could be named Dr. Seuss.
Hate you.
The last one is... The last one misses.
Okay. I never even thought of that, too. And you know all of my names off of random generators.
That's awesome.
So the crag cat slashes at Zeus and, holy shit, deals 11 slashing damage.
No one messes with the
11. And what do I roll to for concentration check? Just a d20?
It's a constitution save.
Yeah, it's a constitution save for concentration.
The DC is 10 or half the damage, whichever is higher. Yeah, that passes. So it is Maxwell's turn.
Maxwell is going to take aim at the one that just hit Zeus. Vantage with sharpshooter. And pepperbox or shortbow. Pepperbox or shortbow. Shortbow. Yeah.
And that kills it.
And
brings us.
Bonus action hide.
Okay. Which brings us to Zeus.
Zeus is going to just go ahead, just use a Stormwalker and then Guiding Bolt. The last one. And.
That misses.
Zeus's child.
For the record, I've never hit with a Guiding Bolt.
I have. That's the sad part. And that will be it.
Okay. The remaining crag cat disengages and begins to run away. Let me
check
its speed real quick.
Can it outrun Zeus and Jid?
Can it outrun the arrow that I'm about to shoot in its head?
Can it outrun Vegeta?
Hold on.
That's a no.
No. Aoife, it's your turn.
How far away is it?
55 feet.
Well, that's from...
From me.
40 feet. It's 40 feet away from you. Well, that's straight line. You're 20 feet up, so Pythagoras, but, you know.
We're not here to do crazy math numbers, all right? We let the computers do that. What's the range of Guiding Bolt?
It's like 100. It's 120 feet.
Coolio. Let's do that.
Okay.
and it is too far away for my spiritual weapon to catch up to it.
Shouldn't your radiant soul bonus be 6 now?
Oh yeah. I forgot.
It is on its last limbs.
All right, who's gonna get the final hit on this fucking thing?
Well, probably Vegeta, because he'll have advantage on the attack.
Yep.
Bad kitty.
You little shit.
That's kind of frightening. You just rolling up on him like that.
You think you're going, you little shit?
Holy shit, your speed is 50. Did you take mobile at 3?
Imagine Step of the Wind.
You did take mobile at 3. That barely hits, and it kills.
Good, because Zeus was about to charge.
All right, and considering... that completes the combat.
I'd like to think that everybody was just ready to fucking kill that thing.
Yeah, that took like...
Every fucking person.
That took 18 seconds. It's crazy.
Every single person in the party was just bloodlusted right now. Just... Like, at first it was like, they're cute. Maybe we should try to, scare them away.
Good God.
Kill one and scare them away. And then it just devolved into... Kill them all.
Then there's feet. Yeah, and then if you also had the Great Weapon Master feat, you could get a plus 15 to it.
Like, literally everybody's reaction to that cat running away was, can it outrun this?
Can I outrun this? No, it cannot.
So after the last cat dies, Aoife slowly descends to the ground. Her wings evaporate, and her eyes go back to their normal color. She perks up and goes, "What happened?" Dead kitties.
Dead kitties.
Aoife, dearest, they're just asleep. They ate lots of cranberries, and they're all asleep.
How do you explain this one whose head smashed in?
It was born that way.
That one was born that way. That's exactly what I was going to say, God.
It's fine. It's okay.
It's fine. The arrow in some of the heads and the stab wound in another is nothing. It's just...
That didn't happen.
It's napping. It's a costume idea. C pulls out the arrow through the other end. It's fine!
Aoife just immediately runs up to these cats and immediately is just spamming Spare the Dying on them.
Well, they are that does stabilize them.
But they're dead. They're not living creatures. They're dead.
Yeah, they are dead.
She's trying to spam Spare the Dying on them, and it's just not working.
Maxwell is just going to pull her off. It's okay, dear. And just pull her into a hug. It's okay, dear. It's okay. We'll get Boris to turn into one of them. It's okay.
It's the kitties.
The kitties tried to eat us. The kitties definitely tried to eat. Would you rather them eat us and they live happily, or... Would you rather they go on to live happy, happy lives up in heaven with other people like you, who are so nice and peaceful and would feed them every day? Would you rather they stay here and have to fend for themselves, or go up where everything is made for them?
Okay.
I know, it's hard. It's very hard. But hey, look. Boris can turn into one of them, most likely.
Dressed to anything that he's seen.
Yep, yes. I'm just restoring you guys to marching order.
Vegeta's just gonna squash
and
head real quick.
And hey, Jid still has his horsey half. They were probably gonna eat that. But But now you can still ride on him, huh?
And Jid still has candy.
Jid still has candy. I still have candy. Hell, do you want Frosted Flakes or Lucky Charms for breakfast tomorrow?
I've got tricks. I'm having tricks for breakfast tomorrow. It's going to be great.
I'm going to have boiled eggs.
I'm going to have ham and rice.
It's good.
That's just...
I have to turn my phone.
So, don't worry. They'll be fine, Aoife. They'll be fine. Lots of cranberries. Lots and lots of cranberries. Slowly wipes the blood off his rapier. Lots and lots of cranberries.
All right, considering the time, I think we're going to call that end.
Yes, this is great. This is great.
Lots, this is a nice and productive
lots of
section.
Cranberries.
Lots and lots of cranberries.
That's what you should name this episode.
Lots and lots of cranberries.
Lots and lots of cranberries.
Okay, so I built something. I built something earlier, and please tell me it saved properly. Why is it going in like that?
Don't worry, I can click on it.
It's just a file.
Which means you didn't save it as a picture. That's damn it.
One minute. What was it, like a JPEG?
Yeah.
Okay, I got it.
Lots and lots of cranberries.
Oh, that.
Yeah.
She looks so terrified. I swear to God, it really does look like she is scared for her life.
Well, she's supposed to be laughing in it, and I couldn't really get a good laugh. There we go. Couldn't really get a good laughing face, though. It's supposed to be a full smile with an open jaw. So yes, that is how I picture Aoife when she brings her wings out. You're welcome.
Thank you very much.
And you're welcome for fixing your file.
Yes, thank you for that too.
All right.
Yeah, it was a simple fix. I just put .jpg on the end of it, and it fixed it.
Tell it, hey, read it like this, instead of just seeing it. See it. Read it. Don't see it. Damn fucking computer.
That's actually how I would turn crap in late, is I would get like a Word document, like however much progress I'm in, I would rename it as a text file and then delete part of the code and then put it back as a Word document thing, and then it gets corrupted.
And then you turn it in, they're like, well, your file got corrupted. Would you mind turning it in? It's like, yeah, sure. Now all of a sudden you have more time.
Yeah, it's like, when I get home tonight, I can send it back in. They don't know what time I'm getting home. Are we still recording?
Yes, we are.
All right. I was trying not to break the nth wall there.
I totally did.
Anyways.
Y'all have no clue how happy I was to find out that she could hold a lollipop in that picture. Like, y'all have no fucking clue.
Holy shit. My sneak attack damage goes up to 4d6 max level. Happy.
Wow.
I am killing the recording, so say goodnight, everybody.
Good night. Good night.
Bye. Sleep well, peoples. We'll see you next, whenever this... We'll see you, whenever the next episode gets uploaded.
Go to sleep, bitches.